independent India. In 74 years, how far did we reach in that destiny which was visualized by all our freedom fighters? Three profound lines from Nehruji's speech can define the beginning. To bring freedom and opportunity to the common man, to the peasants and workers of India. To fight and end poverty and ignorance and disease. To build up a prosperous, democratic and progressive nation. And to create social, economic and political institutions which will ensure justice and fullness of life to every man and woman. Let me repeat this again. To bring freedom and opportunity to the common man, to the peasants and workers of India. To fight and end poverty and ignorance and disease. To build up a prosperous, democratic and progressive nation. And to create social, economic and political institutions which will ensure justice and fullness of life to every man and woman.
Quote one more line from the same speech. The ambition of the greatest man of our generation was to wipe every tear from every eye. This may be beyond us, but as long as there's tears and suffering, so long our work will not be over. He was referring to Gandhiji, whose ambition was to wipe every tear from every eye. Nehru was practical enough to admit that this may be beyond our capacities to wipe every tear, but the message was to work till all suffering vanishes.
In 2020, we're almost 1.3 billion people now. There are tears and there is suffering, but there is also progress and development. In 2019 alone, India has become the fifth largest economy in the world. In 2020, we might be less, not because we're not doing it right, but because of the current pandemic situation we are in. But one may ask, what about the tears and suffering? And what about the suffering? Well, honestly, until this pandemic hit all of the humanity, I was constantly telling myself that there is more good than bad, that there is more progress and development than poverty and sorrow. Until I recently saw the tears of migrant workers and heard many such stories, which then made me realize that I was just living in a myth. These inequities in our society are just heartbreaking. Take for example, right now, many children of my age may not be having two square meals a day. For many, going to school is still a distant possibility. And for many who can go to school but cannot because of the current situation we are in. Lakhs of children like me are at home, not going to school, deprived of learning, deprived of education, deprived of schooling, only because they cannot afford the access to technology. So in a society where there are inequities of such heights, how can I live a happy life? And what kind of a society will I live in?
Now, what can we do as young people? We are still school-going pupils, dependent on our parents. Now, wait a minute. Why did I say that? When I know that I am growing up with the belief that my school has given me and my country, we grow together. Most of us have been saying these words many times. Some of us know a lot about it, but some a little. But why did the school coin this title, me and my country, we grow together? I need some clarity here. And most importantly, why should a school do this? Isn't the purpose of a school to prepare students for exams? I guess the only people who can throw some light into this are our managing director, Dhananjay sir, and director education, Sita Murthy ma'am. Ma'am, sir, answers please.
Good question, Sruti, that why the school should teach that you and your country should grow together. If the only purpose of a school is to prepare the children for exams, then it is a sin. Gandhiji said that knowledge without character is a deadly sin. If the school teach you for the test, then they are losing a great opportunity to groom generations of children who can be nation builders. A society needs knowledgeable people, but it also needs the same people with values. We in Silver Oaks created a collective vision It is shared vision by all the teachers in the school that you and all other children who join us will be taught how to find a purpose in life and live for that purpose, and how you should apply everything that you learn and lead yourself with determination. Once you do all this, you will begin to leave a timeless legacy.
Destiny of a nation begins in its classrooms, and we in Silver Oaks assume the responsibility to shape that destiny. And that's how we thought, while teaching the young people who come to our school the subjects, the skills that need to be competent in this world, let us also build the responsibility in them that me and my country, we grow together. The Civic and Social Responsibility Program was born in 2006 because it was a collective vision. It was a shared vision. All of us sat, the teachers, the director, all of us together, we sat and we visualized when the students who pass out of our school and when they go into the big world out there, that world should be beautiful and this young person should make a better world too. And that's how me and my country, we grow together, was born. What did we do through that? We did we have taken up many initiatives to instill that feeling, that responsibility that you can make a difference even today when you are just 4 years old, 5 years old, 10 years old, 13 years old. And how did we do it? We started a resolution campaign. 2006 was the first resolution campaign, which was kicked off on the 15th August in 2006. And the resolutions were for civic responsibility and social responsibility, that I will take care of my neighborhood. I will make sure that everything is clean in and around my house. I will make sure that I will not destroy any public property. There were many resolutions like that. And regarding the social responsibility, the resolutions were that I will be kind and respectful, that I will be positive and progressive at all times, and I will help others being positive. So there were many resolutions. Back then, the class of 2006 made sure that all the visitors who have come to the school on Independence Day have taken these resolutions. From there, we took it one more step ahead. We started something called Coins for the Country. And how was it born? The first 2-3 years, we identified these community schools under Rural Development Foundation. And we asked our students, like typically it was done until then, anywhere in the world, that raise funds. Ask your parents, ask your relatives, ask your neighbors, get money, and then let's give it to this community school. I still remember one of the parents had sent a message that, I don't want my daughter to go to any neighbor and ask for funds because they don't speak with respect. They talk with suspicion when the moment fundraising is talked about. And it hit us so badly that mail. Sometimes I really have a lot to thank the parents for, because how they taught us so many things. I also imagine the same thing, because when I was in school, I remember when I used to go for fundraising, how that person would have a different look on his face or her face. And immediately that year we called it off and we said, no, our ACONs will not go to ask for funds from anybody. And then the idea was born that let them save, let them earn money in a span of 6 months in every academic year. Let us give them a kiddie bank, an earthen pot, and in that, let them learn that while I am growing up, I should help the country grow too. And that's how the Coins for the Country initiative started, from one step to the next step to the next step. And today, 2020, 15th August, it is my privilege and highly heartwarming to say this, that all the ACONs and all our 4 schools together have contributed 1.5 crores to the community for the education of the less privileged. What can a school do to shape the destiny of a nation? This is what it can do, not the money. Young people growing up with the responsibility that I can build the destiny of the nation. And that's exactly what is the contribution of Silver Oaks in shaping the destiny of the nation.
When you give, you know yourself better. We created a culture of giving through Coins for the Country in the school. It is not about the money. It is about how you can sacrifice your own wants to give it to others. I will quote Gandhiji again. He said that it is in the service of others that we will know our true selves. When you are saving or earning money and keep it in the coins pot, each time you do it, you are learning how to control your own temptation to buy something and help someone. This is a value which will change your life. Last year, when I donated 1 crore to Akshay Patra Foundation, I visualized how 9,000 children will get lunch every day for 1 year with that money. That vision helped me overcome the temptation to use that money for some other purpose. Meeting the hunger of thousands of people is more soul-satisfying than anything.